Attorney Roque, it's wonderful to see you back on Headstart.
Yes, good morning, Karen. It's always a privilege. But let me start off by saying that as counsel to President Rodrigo Roque Duterte, no, he and I met last night, and he has made his position very clear on the ICC. No? Mm. Now that he is no longer president, he no longer has immunity from suit. All those who have gripes or complaints against him should file their criminal complaints before a Philippine prosecutor. And if there is probable cause, he is willing to face them, but before a Philippine court. And if he's found guilty for violating the Philippine IHL law, which restates the crimes punishable under the ICC, then he will face the consequences and face time in a Philippine jail. Under no circumstance will he allow any foreign prosecutor, any foreign judge, any foreign court to exercise jurisdiction over him. And this, Karen, of course, is consistent with the principle of complementarity. When we became a member of the ICC, and you're correct, I was actually chairperson of the ICC for the coalition at that time when we became a member, we never intended the ICC to be a substitute for domestic legal systems. Mm. It was very clear under the principle of complementarity that the court should only exercise jurisdiction when domestic institutions are unable and or unwilling to exercise jurisdiction. No. There is inability when there is in fact no virtual government working. No. And if you look at the cases pending in the ICC, many of the cases involve Sudan, which for all intents and purposes is a failed state. There is no pending criminal cases because there are no courts functioning, no, to punish these individuals. And there is, of course, unwillingness when there are immunity statutes. No? And it's very clear in the Philippines that presidents enjoy only immunity from suit while in office. And we have had two presidents, in fact, who were immediately jailed after their terms of office ended. No? Mm-hmm. So our courts, our legal institutions are neither unwilling or unable. And complainants should file their cases before Philippine institutions and not the ICC. He also said, and actually this idea came from him, no? And I was really impressed because it's an idea that I did not even think of. No, it really was his solution. No? Mm-hmm. That if for any reason that the ICC will continue to exercise its jurisdiction, he will go before Philippine courts for a restraining order to restrain the Philippine police from serving the warrant of arrest against him because he will argue that the Philippine courts are able and willing to prosecute these cases. And therefore, there's no basis for foreign institutions to interfere. And this is a consequence of being a sovereign country.
No, all right. Okay. Wow. That must have been a very long meeting, Attorney Roque. Can yes. you share behind the scenes a bit? Where did you see the former president? What issues did you discuss specifically other than the two you've just announced?
We met in Rizal Park Hotel. Okay. It was attended by former Executive Secretary Medial Dea, by Solicitor General Maynard Guevara, mm-hmm. By myself, and then there's PCGG chairman, if I'm not mistaken, and DOJ, someone from the Department of Justice as well. No, mm-hmm. The sole topic was really the ICC. No, mm-hmm. And it took about 4 hours. No, I had to excuse myself because I have an early day today. No, but I left the meeting at around 11, and we started at 6.
Okay. Now, for the president, the former president, to meet with you regarding the ICC, would it be fair to say he's actually quite concerned?
Well, he just wants to make it very clear that he has been consistent on his position on the ICC. Hmm. No one should interfere with the domestic legal processes of a sovereign state unless it is shown that we have a failed state or that our criminal justice system has completely stopped from working, no? Again, compare us with Sudan, a country where many of the cases being tried by the ICC happened. No, this is not the case as far as the Philippines is concerned. And personally, as a member of the Philippine Bar, I will never admit that our courts are unable or willing to exercise jurisdiction over crimes which are cognizable by domestic courts here in the Philippines.
All right. I wanted to ask you on a personal capacity. You were also tapped by President Marcos Jr. to be his private counsel regarding the ICC. If a case is filed against former President Duterte regarding the drug war, does this mean you will be his lawyer?
Well, I think we need to emphasize that I could become his lawyer. For all intents and purposes, I am counsel for President Duterte as well, no?
Okay.
Because I have given legal advice. Yeah. Although I know President Marcos, he did not give me 20 pesos, so he owes me 20 pesos, no?
Mm-hmm.
But he has not retained the services of counsel in the ICC because I'm also a list counsel member of the ICC.
Until today, sir.
Okay, which means he has no intentions of allowing the ICC to have jurisdiction over his person, no? And that is why he is ready with the legal remedy of going to a Philippine court to restrain the PNP from enforcing any warrant for arrest if in fact one is issued by the ICC. And his basic ground, of course, is that we are a sovereign state, we are not a failed state, and therefore the ICC has no jurisdiction because it is only complementary to Philippine legal system.
Okay, you're in a very curious and interesting situation, given that you're in the list of counsels in the ICC. Are you in a quandary? Should you be advocating for the ICC investigation for the Philippines? Is that required of you, Attorney Roque? I mean, at one point, being palace spokesperson, I would understand you'd have to take the stand of the president, but now you're a private citizen. What happens now with your position in the ICC?
Well, these counsels are defense counsels primarily, although some of us can also represent victims. No, in fact, in the Philippine situation, I'm counseling for a former president, but in the Russian situation, I've been retained by Ukraine. No,
I
represent victims. No,
that's interesting.
Like any other court, we're a bar association. No. And it's important that both victims and accused should have competent representation before the courts. But I completely agree with the position of the president. Because again, you have to look at the countries where the ICC has exercised jurisdiction. These are, for all intents and purposes, failed states with no functioning courts. That is not the case. And I challenge all the complainants in the ICC to file their cases before Philippine institutions. Because I have filed cases for extralegal killings. Have you forgotten Maguindanao massacre case?
Yes.
That resulted in multiple convictions for 57 counts of murder because one case was dismissed. No? Pemberton was convicted, albeit given probation. There's another torture case that's still being tried in court, Evangelista, the suspected thief whose private parts were tied to a door. No? So my challenge to these lawyers filing cases in the ICC is, why were you not filing cases in the Philippines in the first place? Mm-hmm. I know for a fact that the Supreme Court has taken cognizance of a petition for the issuance of writ of amparo, and the Supreme Court has in fact asked the PNP through the OSG to account for all the cases of killings. No, so there is in fact an ongoing Supreme Court investigation on these killings, no less. So why would the foreign court exercise jurisdiction when no less than the Philippine Supreme Court has taken cognizance of the matter? This goes to the very heart of treaty consent to be bound to the ICC. We never agreed to surrender domestic jurisdiction. Only that when our systems don't work, then the ICC should exercise jurisdiction.
Okay, now going to the process of the ICC, because you are one of the listed counsels and an expert in international law, when the ICC prosecutor requested the resumption of the investigation, and now that President Marcos Jr. has stated we will not rejoin, just how far can the ICC go, Attorney Roque? I mean, has there been a precedence that resembles something like this?
Many. There's been an investigation which was discontinued by the prosecution because they were convinced that domestic institutions were working. And this is the case of the UK on the atrocities committed against Iraqi POWs. No? Lately, there has been a decision of the ICC refusing to confirm charges against an accused. No? Also on the basis that domestic court should be allowed. No? Put it this way. No? The court has limited resources. Take note that the United States, China, and Russia are not members of the court.
And even Israel.
It's exclusively being funded by the EU and Japan. So they have limited resources. They have limited manpower. The ICC, in fact, has had to advertise a position for the Philippines, no? Because they're very busy trying to investigate how to prosecute the Russians in Ukraine. No? So they also have to prioritize their time. So my thinking is, given the principle of complementarity, all that they want is an assurance from the Philippines that they will investigate these cases and would gladly relinquish their jurisdiction over the investigation on the drug war. It's definitely not enough resources, not enough manpower to do it. No, they cannot exercise as a court of primary jurisdiction for the entire planet Earth.
So what do you say to these organizations that have actually said that they don't trust the local courts to hear the case against former President Duterte fairly?
No basis. Because I've prosecuted very politically powerful individuals called the Ampatuans and convicted them for multiple murders at that. Of course, the conviction was not perfect because it took 10 years. But that's not to say that we are unable or unwilling. We can do it. And my challenge is file it here in the Philippines. And that is why I'm somehow concluding that the reason why they went to the ICC is really just to embarrass the former president. No? But our institutions are working. And in fact, if these lawyers representing them in the ICC are not convinced that our institutions are working, then they should resign from the Philippine legal profession. They have no business being officers of the court if they think our courts are unable or unwilling to give justice to Filipinos.
Okay. Attorney Roque, you've been through this. I mean, clearly your personal history with the ICC, it's almost gotten, you've gone full circle, frankly speaking.
Not go full circle. Complementarity is at the core of the ICC. No country agreed to surrender their sovereignty. No country agreed to surrender their primary jurisdiction over these crimes. I'm simply being consistent. It's not a case of flip-flopping. It's a case of this is the reason why we decided to become bound by the treaty. And these are also the same reasons why other countries agreed. They never agreed to surrender their sovereignty. The ICC should only be a court of last resort.
Okay. Actually, I was going to that because I reviewed our 2018 interview on Headstart, the transcript of it. And that was when President Duterte withdrew from the ICC. And you said then that you believe the ICC, this is the beginning of the end.
Yes.
That was a quote you said on the show.
Yes.
Because remember, you said not one ASEAN country was joining the ICC, and you turned out right. Yes. Remember?
We have two, Cambodia and Timor-Leste, but beyond that, none of our neighbors are joined. And I stand by that.
You stand by that.
If they persist in the investigation in the Philippines, that will convince other countries that, in fact, the ICC is bent on infringing on sovereignty. In fact, I know for a fact that the African Union, the entire membership of the entire African Union, is at the brink of withdrawing from the ICC. And it is precisely because of this reason that they feel that the principle of complementarity is being disregarded by the former prosecutor of the court. No? So remove I think it's only a matter of time before the African Union countries in fact withdraw.
Okay.
You will only be left with Europe and some countries of Latin America as members of the ICC.
Okay, I'll ask you something political. Do you believe that the ICC is losing credibility simply because the United States, which was one of the countries that was at the forefront of actually putting the ICC together, refuses to have war crimes possibly committed by their own soldiers against Afghanistan investigated by the ICC? Do you think, Attorney Roque, this is one major piece in the ICC problem?
Their problem is the big countries, permanent member nations of the Security Council, are not members of the ICC, including the United States. The United States, in fact, despite the fact that the drafters of the Rome Statute accommodated all the concerns of the ICC, their number one concern was the non-accountability of a prosecutor who, as we now learn, can actually happen, has no accountability and can charge sitting presidents and cause political problems for them. No? So what they did was, in order to address the issue of accountability, because in the U.S. prosecutors are elected, they decided to form a pretrial chamber to affirm and confirm all actions of the prosecutor. And that is why the prosecutor has had to go back to the court itself and say, I'm resuming my preliminary investigation, give me authority to do so. No? But despite that, the United States has never become a member of the ICC together with Russia and the and China. And yeah. for that matter, neither is Ukraine a member of the ICC, which is now the quandary on how to hold Russia responsible for the war crimes that it's committing, given that neither Russia nor the territory where the war crimes happen are members of the ICC. Though. So I think the way to strengthen the ICC is to go the exact opposite way that the former prosecutor took, no? Honor the principle of complementarity. Mm-hmm. When they prosecute cases in Sudan where there is a failed state, the entire community is supportive of the ICC. Mm-hmm. But when you have a country like the Philippines, which in fact was instrumental in the creation of the ICC because much of the principles of the Rome Statute is based on Philippine jurisprudence, In re Yamashita and Kuroda, no? Mm-hmm. Versus the president, no? They better think twice. Mm-hmm. We have one of the most mature legal systems in the world in terms of jurisprudence. We predated the jurisprudence of Nuremberg in arguing in the ruling that even without a domestic law, war crimes can be punished, no, under customary international law. So this is one of the most advanced, one of the most sophisticated legal systems in the world. And for the ICC now to investigate as if our courts are able and willing, is really a gross insult to our legal institutions.
Two last questions, Attorney Roque. During the campaign, President Marcos Jr. said he would only allow the ICC to come in the Philippines as tourists. With the way he sounded, we would not be rejoining. I was wondering, did that even change? Would he even allow ICC officials or members to come into the country, even as tourists?
You know, anything that I've discussed with President Marcos cannot be divulged because of the confidentiality. And that's why I had to be paid 20 pesos, no? Because in that meeting, I was the only non-cabinet member in attendance, no? And I was not subject to executive privilege. Unfortunately, I can't discuss anything that was discussed in meetings between me and President Marcos. But in the case of President Duterte, he authorized me, in fact, to divulge what I just mentioned today.
All right. Okay. And moving forward, what does the Philippines stand to lose if we don't join the ICC?
Nothing, because our courts are working. But of course, in the event, for example, of invasion and there are no legal systems working, then they may not be a court of last resort. But I'd like to emphasize, no, the ICC is a court of last resort. Domestic courts are always the court of primary jurisdiction.
All right. On that note, Attorney Harry Roque, it's a pleasure to see you once again on the Headstart. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you and have a good day.